Hello everybody and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you for such wonderful reviews on the previous video of orthopedic appliances. Since you all have loved the videos earlier and I've got the feedback wherein you have understood each and everything about headgear, I have come up with face mask and chin cup in a combined video. Okay, so I'm so sure since you all have understood the previous video, so face mask and headgear should be easier for you people to understand. Okay, so yes, students, let me tell you that we are coming up with a test series very, very soon. But it is my humble request that before you attempt that test series, please go through the videos first. Otherwise, there is no use in simply attempting the MCQs without having any previous knowledge about it. Okay, because we do not wish to mug up the answers of the questions, but we need to understand the concept first and then go for the MCQs. Okay. So, without wasting any time, let us start with the concept of face mask. See, we have read the basics of orthopedic appliances and that is something which we applied in the headgear. Now, face mask is used to, see, we saw that headgear was for what? Class 2 cases. Okay, now face mask is something which is used in class 3 cases. Okay. And in the previous video, we have seen the features, extraoral features of a class 3 patient, wherein the profile of the patient is concave. The etiology of class 3, whatever, whether genetic or because of some external features or any factors, how does it present itself? It presents itself with a retrognathic maxilla and a protracted mandible, or it could be a combination of both the factors, okay? Assuming that in the patient which has showed up in your clinic, the class 3 is because of retroded mandible, so we give a face mask, okay? And the name for face mask is protraction face mask. Why? Because it is used to protract your maxilla, okay? Why? Because the maxilla is retroded, it has to be brought forward in an orthognathic position, so the maxilla has to be protracted. Therefore, it is known as a protraction face mask. And since its use is exactly opposite to that of headgear, it is also known as reverse pull headgear. Why? Because headgear was distalizing our maxilla and face mask is protracting our maxilla. That is completely two opposite things. Okay. So do not get confused, students, because in 2014 or 2015, there was an MCQ wherein they had mentioned, the MCQ was tell me the usage of a reverse pull headgear. So the students got confused over there and they actually picked the use of a headgear. But if they have mentioned the terminology reverse pull headgear, it means they are talking about face mask. So yes, this is one important thing which you people need to remember. Now, face mask earlier was given by Hickham and Dallaire. Right, and things which you need to know over here is, first thing is the site of anchorage. Now, why I have only written the name of the topics, because you know anchorage, you know what is anchorage. In headgear, what was the site of anchorage? In face mask, the site of anchorage is either your forehead and your forehead and the chin area. So what happens, my face mask take anchorage from the forehead and from the chin, and with the help of these rubber bands, it will pull my maxilla outside. Okay, so imagine the patient is there with retruded maxilla and my patient's profile is concave. So with the help of these two anchorage units, it will take support from here, and with the help of rubber bands, my maxilla will be pulled outside. Okay, duration of wear. You should be able to answer this. Duration of wear, you all know, 10 to 12 hours in a day. Components, okay, we saw the components in headgear. So, components of face mask, same thing. Anchor unit, okay, these two things from where we are taking anchorage or from where we are taking the support becomes your anchor unit. Okay, this is the force element and this is your face bow. This is not exactly a face bow because there is no outer bow and inner bow. But this is the place where this gets inserted intraorally because of the rubber bands which are used. And rubber bands deliver the forces. Okay. Now, with the evolution, there were different type of face masks because different orthodontists came up with different concept. Then, suppose the first, very first face mask, maybe if it was Tubinger. So what do you see? That there is, it is in the shape of a tube and it is covering entire head and it is coming through your nose and getting inserted into the chin area. So obviously over a period of time, people must have noticed that the assembly is not very comfortable to the patient. Okay, the assembly is huge. The patient is not able to wear it. So they made a compact design. Okay, so they came up with a compact design. Then came the concept of Dallaire type of face mask. Do you see how the assembly has reduced? Now it is extended only onto the forehead. And this portion, which this tube region, which was passing very close to the nose, has come into this area now. See, this is how it came. So this was basically evolution occurring. Right, there are the changes which are taking place over a period of time, where all the drawbacks of a particular appliance is being taken care of. Again, new people came up, new evolution came up, and they came up with a further compact design, that is the petit type. And it's very common and most important ones which are used. So petit type, you see, is way more compact as compared to Dallaire and Tubinger. Okay, so these are the three types of face masks. You should be knowing the names. Tubinger, Dallaire and petit type of face mask. Okay, so this is basically little basics about face mask. See students, orthopedic appliances is a huge and a vast topic. Before we get into the depth of anything, before you hold the textbooks and start reading the face mask in depth, you should be very, very thorough with the basics of it. That's why I'm helping you just brush up through your basics. That is, face mask is used in correction of class 3 malocclusion. It helps to protract my maxilla, that is, move my maxilla ahead by using what? Using these two anchor units, okay? And you know the amount of force applied ranges from 300 to 500 grams. Duration of wear is 10 to 12 hours in a day, preferably in evening at night, because that is the time when my growth hormones are released by the anterior pituitary gland. Ideal age for giving this is mixed dentition, that is, during 6 to 12 years of age. The different types of face masks which are there, these three types, okay? So since we have already covered basics in the very first video, all you need to know about face masks, because basics are already covered. Next thing which we have is our chin cup. Before we start with chin cup, one thing which you need to know is it is banned in India, okay? Chin cups are no longer used in India. They have been banned because of their extreme side effects. They had multiple drawbacks, therefore it has been banned. Okay, now let us see what is chin cup. Chin cup is an extraoral orthopedic appliance which is used to restrict the forward and downward growth of the mandible. So yes, chin cup is also given in case of class 3 malocclusions, that is, in patients with skeletal class 3, wherein my mandible is prognathic. Okay, when my chin is protruded, my maxilla is fine, but my mandible is protracted, we give chin cup. So that is why, can you appreciate why face mask and chin cup are covered together? Because both of them are used in class 3 cases. So when you see a patient of class 3, if your maxilla is affected, that is, it is retruded, you will give a face mask. If your maxilla is fine and the problem lies in the mandible, that is, your mandible is protruding, you will give a chin cup, right? So I hope you are able to relate why we are covering these two things together, okay? And how we have covered class 3 cases all together at one go. So class 3 problems, you know, is because of retruded maxilla, protruded mandible, or it could be a combination of the two things. If you see a patient has retruded maxilla, you will give a face mask. If the patient has protruded mandible, you will give a chin cup, right? So these two extraoral appliances are used in the management of class 3 and malocclusion. My chin cup helps in redirection of growth of the mandible. It restricts the forward and downward growth so that it cannot grow further and worsen my class 3. Okay, now types of chin cup. What are the components of chin cup? Again, there is a force element, there is an anchor unit, and there is this, a chin cup portion. It can take anchorage from parietal region, occipital region, or it can be used in both the ways. Duration of it, people know 10 to 12 hours when, again, evening time, amount of force applied, 300 to 500 grams. So these things are common, which you know for all the appliances. Okay, so this is your occipital pull chin cup and this is your parietal pull chin cup. And why they are banned in India is because, see, from the design, if you can make out, chin cup applies a lot of force in this region. when a lot of force is applied in mandible, my entire force gets transmitted to my TMJ. Okay, all the force gets transmitted to TMJ. Now, because of the high forces which are used in orthopedic appliances, 300 to 500 grams of forces are used. And if this force gets transmitted to my TMJ, the posterior border started getting damaged. Okay, there were changes seen in the temporomandibular joint of the patients, which ultimately led to pain in TMJ, clicking, crepitations, and all these things. So instead of doing more good, it used to harm the patient. So keeping this particular thing in mind, it was banned in India. Okay, all the nerve supply, blood supply, it used to get, you know, affected. Right, because posterior to this TMJ, we have a very rich nerve supply. So based on this concept, the people thought that it is good to ban the chin cups. It is no longer used, but it is something which you need to know from your NEET MBBS point of view. Right, so if you have understood all the three lectures of orthopedic appliances, basics, next was headgear. This is combination of face mask and chin cup. You should be able to answer these three things. Tell me the force magnitude or the amount of force applied in orthopedic appliances. It should click into your mind by now that 300 to 500 grams of force is applied. Duration of wear. You should be able to tell it yourself. The patient wears it 10 to 12 hours a day. Most importantly, drawbacks of these. Okay, so what I would recommend you is just pause the video for some time. Mention all the drawbacks. Write down all the drawbacks in your mind, or you can write it in a notebook. And now when I am enlisting the drawbacks, you should be able to compare whether you came up with these points or not. So this would be a little self-evaluation for you people. So yes, the drawbacks of orthopedic appliances or extraoral appliances are: first drawback, aesthetics. The aesthetics are completely compromised. Okay, this is very obvious. Next, the patient cannot eat or drink anything while wearing the appliance. Next, the patient is very much prone to injuries. Okay, obviously, if the patient doesn't wear it properly, in case it gets dislodged, if the patient gets harmed from anybody else, if the patient is a young patient, okay, he's just a 6 to 12 year old boy or a girl. So maybe when they're going out to play, they can get injured. Okay, the eye can get injured. So yes, there are chances of injuries. What else can you think of? When a patient is wearing extraoral appliance, you have to depend on the patients for their compliance. Okay, so patient's compliance becomes a problem. What else can you think of? So basically, when you see a patient is wearing extraoral appliance, yes, aesthetics is compromised, patient is not able to eat or drink anything, the patient can get injured, there is patient compliance problem, it becomes a very huge problem. Next thing, it is not even very easy for the orthodontist to deliver the appliance. A lot of work goes into delivering an extraoral appliance, right from, you know, identifying the center of resistance of maxilla, okay, then delivering the appliance, adjusting it properly, okay, depending on patient that, yes, patient will wear it, okay, and then adjusting it every month, there is lab work involved and all these things. So yes, it is not a very feasible thing for orthodontist as well. So yes, these were the drawbacks of orthopedic appliances, right? So if there is any other drawback which you have come across, which I have not mentioned, very good. You should be able to think of few more things like that, okay? And yes, the patient is very young when we are giving this, and in case we cannot take use of the growth, the patient has to finally then go in for surgery, or, you know, then orthodontic treatment is carried out. So that is, yes, one more thing which you can add to the list of drawbacks. After giving orthopedic appliance, my treatment does not get over. The patient has to go in for orthodontic treatment as well. Yes, I have corrected the skeletal jaw basis by using orthopedic appliances. But what about my teeth? My dental changes have to be brought about as well. So yes, after completing orthopedic appliance, we go for orthodontic treatment also. So in total, the sixth point which you can come is the duration of treatment. The duration of in total treatment becomes very long, because first few years of orthopedic, then orthodontic treatment. Okay, so students, this was all about face mask and chin cup. Please note that only basics have been covered. In case you feel you need to read more, you can always get back to textbooks. Soon I'll be covering you, which we'll be covering which textbooks to be used also. And yes, if you have any doubt, you can write down in the comment section below. With this, we finish off with the basic series of orthopedic appliances. Okay, this entire series was on orthopedic appliances, wherein we were covering everything, all the basic things were covered. So yes, just wait for the next topic to start. Okay, so all the very best students for your preparation. Have a great day. Thank you. Thank you very much.